Hello, everyone. Today, I'm giving you a complete walkthrough and guide of how to use Apple Calendar. This is the built-in calendar app on your Mac, iPhone, iPad, any Apple device. So whether you're a beginner looking to master the features or someone who kind of knows how to use it and you want to learn a few different things, I'll have it timestamped down below where you can jump to different sections if you already know how to do most of it, but you want to learn a bit about a specific topic. So let's go ahead and jump right in. All right, first things first, as you can see, we have the Apple Calendar opened here on my desktop, and I'll pop up my iPhone to show you what it looks like on mobile as well. And the calendar app is one of the things that I use on a daily basis. So what we're going to do now is we're going to talk about how to sign in with iCloud to make sure that your Apple Calendar is synced up with all your devices. That way you're not struggling to figure out, it's working on my computer or my Mac, but it's not working on my iPad. So what you're going to want to do is go to System Settings. So if you're on a Mac, open up System Settings, and I'll bring this over here. And you want to click on right here where it says your Apple account, right here where it says iCloud. And then what you want to do is you want to go to Apple ID, which we've done here, and make sure that your calendars is enabled. So if we go to iCloud here, you want to go and look at your features here, and you can see if we go to See All right here, you got right here, iCloud Calendar. This right here should be checked on. So this should be checked on where it says iCloud Calendar. Make sure that is the case and then go ahead and click done. On the iPhone, it's very simple. You go over here, you search for settings, and then under settings, you tap on your iCloud account at the very top. You go to iCloud there and then go to See All under Save to iCloud or iCloud Features. And you want to make sure that your iCloud Calendar is set to on. So just make sure that is set to on. Once you've done that, it should sync up on all your devices as long as your iCloud settings are appropriate. Next, we're going to do an overview of the main interface. This is the main interface. It's very simple. It's just a calendar. You have different views. You can view a day view. You can do the week view. You have the month view. And then if you really want to zoom out, you can go to the year view. If you're looking for, hey, what is that date in September that we're off or out of school? You can look at the kind of overhead or top-down view from the year. I prefer the week view because it lets me know the different days, what's going on. And then if I really want to get granular, I'll go into the day view to kind of put specific things in there. But for the purposes of the video, I'm going to keep it in the month view here. So that's really all you need to know about the interface. And then on the left-hand side here, if we click on the calendar icon in the top left corner, it will bring out the sidebar where we can take a look at all of our different calendars. Now, there are internal calendars, which you create within the iCloud system within the, calendar system here in Apple. And then you see here, I have a Gmail calendar, which is syncing from my Google calendar over to my iCal. And I'll show you how to do all of that here shortly. So that's kind of what's going on with the interface. All right, next section, let's talk about creating and managing events. The easiest way of doing it is find the day that you want to add the event. Say you have an event tomorrow, click in that day. So double click in that day, and it will bring up the option to create an event or a reminder. So for the case of this video, we're going to create a new event. So we'll go ahead and type the event name here. So whatever that event may be, we'll go ahead and do that. And then you have a couple of options to add invitees. You can add notes or a URL. You can add a location. You can give it a color. You can select this drop-down menu here to give it a calendar. Now, iCloud or the iCal comes with what they believe to be, the most common calendars. Work, home, family. I've added one here that has my name on it. So you can, basically choose which calendar you want that to be added to. You can click off and you can see that event is added. The next thing you may want to do is change the time. So if we click here, when we click on the event, you can click on the time there where it says you can choose it to be an all day event or you can have a start and an end time. So we're going to start this event at, say, 11 o'clock a.m. and it's going to last all the way to 1 p.m. So that's a 2-hour meeting. Does it repeat? Now, repeating events are allowing you to basically hit this drop-down menu and say every day from 11 to 1 p.m., this thing is going to happen. Or every week, so every single Thursday, this is going to happen. Or every month, on the last Friday, I'm getting paid, right? Or every year, is it a birthday? You might want to do it every year. But the one you may want to look at is custom. If we click into custom options here, this will allow you to say, okay, during the work week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, every week, right? Once a week on these days, this is going to happen. How do you delete an event? You come into here and you click on the event, you right-click that event, and you go to delete. It's going to ask you, do you want to delete only this day's event? Or if it's a repeating event, it'll say delete all future events. Just go ahead and click into delete all future events. If you ever want to edit an event, you can go ahead and let's say right click this event here and go to get info, or you can just double click the event. It'll bring it up where you can go and change whether it repeats. You can change the location, all the different information you'd be adding to a calendar event. You can just edit by double clicking or right clicking and hit get info. All right, so we know how to add, customize, and edit events, but how do we add specific calendars over here on the left-hand sidebar? So as you can see, if you click the little calendar icon here, like I mentioned earlier, it'll bring up all of your different calendars. If you have any synced from a different service like Google, like I have here, it'll be showing up here. If you have them that are synced with your iCloud, which are the iCal calendars, which is what we're going to add here, they'll show up here. And then there will be other calendars down here. These are just some that I've subscribed to. So in order to add a calendar, you just right click on the sidebar. So if you right click on the sidebar, go to new calendar, it will bring up this calendar. Now, unfortunately, as you can see, when you create a new calendar, it shows up as on my Mac right here. So what you would want to do is you'd want to go here, go to get info, and then you can see you can give that calendar a name. So let's go ahead and say the calendar is for family stuff, right? So we'll go ahead and give the name of the calendar family stuff, and then you can give it a color, say green, and then you can hit OK. But what I want you to do is click on publish. And then you can give the calendar a login and a password, send it out to people, and they can subscribe to it. So let's say I create a calendar for my favorite sports team's games. I can then publish that on the web, give them a base URL with a login and a password, hit publish, and anyone can access that calendar. So what we want to do is we want to create one that's going to sync between all our devices. And so in order to do that, we would go to File, and then we'd go to New Calendar, and then you have two options. One is iCloud, the other is on my Mac. We want to choose iCloud. By choosing iCloud, it puts it under the iCloud section here, and then what it allows you to do is to sync these between all of your different Apple devices. So this is the one that you probably more than likely want to use. We'll create a calendar for our pets, so give it a name there and hit enter, and then you can always right-click on the calendar, go to get info, and you can change the name, give it a description, you can choose to ignore alerts, and then you can go to calendar info here, and then under calendar info, it will bring up this setting or accounts option here, where on your Mac, you have the iCloud settings here. It lets you know, hey, I want to enable this account. This is iCloud. This is my username. And then refresh calendars, whether it's push or every minute or whatever, you can manually do this, but I choose push, which means that normally it happens as quickly as I add it, right? Just a few minutes. So go ahead and close out of that. And then go ahead and give the color of the calendar and then hit OK. Now we've added a new calendar under iCloud. So now under iCloud, we have a new calendar named Pets. So when we go here and we right click inside of a day, go to New Event, we can choose that calendar. So we have the drop down menu here with the color. That brings up all of our calendars. We want this added to the Pets calendar. So give the event a name, make sure it's added to that new calendar, the time when it's going to happen, and then click off. Now you can see we have a new event called Give Fluffy a Bath. Again, if we look at this on the day view, it's going to look a little bigger. So we can go here. And I failed to mention that you can be viewing this in any view. We can be in the week view and I can double click the event to see the settings. I can be in day view and see it here. And I can right click, hit get info and do it that way. Let's just say you have an event happening, you know, every hour, every other hour on the day. You can right click here. You can copy that event. And then we can go here, right click, and then we can paste here, and you can see we can paste it. And then another cool thing is you can click and hold an event on the day or month or week view, and we can click and hold and drag this. If you're like, oh no, it's actually happening at 2 now, we can drag that to 2 o'clock. Also, you click the event, highlight the event, hit backspace or delete on your keyboard, and that completely deletes and removes that specific event. Now, how do we add or sync a calendar from, say, Gmail? What you would do is you would click on the calendar option here, so the name calendar in the upper left-hand corner, and go to accounts. Now, this is much easier to do. And by the way, everything that we've done here on desktop basically translates one-to-one on the iPhone. So if I bring up my iPhone here, you can see it's very easy to, if I want to, I can just go into a day like today, and then I can just hit the addition symbol there in the upper right-hand corner, and then I can add the event, right? So I can allow paste, going to add that event. And then you give the event a name, hit add, and as you can see, that has added that event. Or if I wanted to, I can tap and highlight that event, go to delete event, just like so. but it is much easier to add calendars on desktop. Just wanted to kind of tell you guys that. All right, back over on the desktop side of things, if we're wanting to add a Gmail calendar or a calendar to sync it with, what we would do is we'd click the account settings here under calendar, and as you can see, I have my Gmail and calendars as well as my iCloud. What you would do is you would go to add account, and then under add account, whether it's an Outlook, you know, calendar, a Google calendar, Yahoo, AOL, iCloud, and there's even an option that says add other account. But what we want to do is we want to select the one that we want to add. Let's say it's a Gmail calendar. Click on Google just like that, and then it's going to open a new browser tab for us. So log into your Gmail account, hit continue like so, and it's going to give you this option here that says, are you sure you want to share your Gmail data or Google data with macOS and iCal? Go ahead and select all at the very top, and then go ahead and click continue. This is then going to allow you to choose, do you want to sync the mail, contacts, calendars, notes? I only want the calendar, so I'm going to deselect everything but the calendar. Once I've done that, I'll click done, just like so. And now, as you can see, here's my new Google account being synced. This is enabled on calendars right here. Now I can go back and see I have the new Google account over here. Now, when we get out of that, we'll exit out of the settings here. On the left-hand sidebar where all of our calendars are listed, here is the new calendar. This is the new calendar that we just added. It should have the Gmail account name here. It should, whatever you've named it, Gmail, email account, whatever. And then it has a new color for that specific calendar. So again, any sub-calendar you create under Gmail, as you can see up here, will also show up under that calendar settings down below on the sidebar. Now we can right-click, new event, and we can give it that color, which means that it is go ahead and add it in that new calendar that we just imported. Now, in order to delete a calendar that you've synced to, you would need to go to the calendar option here, go to accounts, just where we're just at, and then under accounts here, we would select this here, and then you can go here and go to delete account. Are you sure you want to delete that? It'll basically remove the data from the calendar, everything not in the future, but also in the past as well. Click OK, that deletes that, and now you're good to go. So that's how you sync it up to other services. So when you add something on Gmail, it will add it to your iCal as well. So if I go to my Google Calendar, add an event, within minutes, it will sync up to my iCal if I've done this properly. So that's how you do that and add it. All right, next we're going to be talking about notifications and alerts. So if you want to be notified about an event coming up so you can remember it, what you would want to do is right-click on the event, go to Get Info, or double-click on the event. And as you can see, if I click into the timing here, there's an option at the bottom that says Alert. It says one day before. So I want to be alerted here either one day before, I don't want an alert, or on the day of the event. So if I go to on the day of the event, 9 a.m., that's going to let me know that I'll be alerted. Also, a little side note here, if it's an event that repeats, it'll ask you, hey, only for this specific, you know, event here on this day or all future events. You can choose that there. Now, if we go here, you can see where the alert is. Click on that. That's going to allow you to be alerted then. And you can also go to custom and be alerted basically whenever you want. So you can, you know, change the alert to be a message with a sound on your iOS device, email, open the file if there's a file attached. All of those things can be done here under alert. All right, and then the next section is going to be a little bit more about the syncing and integrations. So again, you have to enable Google or Outlook calendars, whatever it is, under the accounts in settings. It's very important. And then if you're on a iOS device, you can enable Siri to basically add events for you. So you can go, hey Siri, please add an event on February 24th at 9 a.m. As you can see, it brings up the title here. I want to call it new event. And then you can see it's created a new event. So that's just a cool thing you can do. That has to be enabled within the Siri settings on your iOS device. All right, now let's talk about just some general settings. If you open up the calendar settings here, click on calendar, go to settings. Under general settings, you can set your default calendar app. So mine is set to be Google Calendar. You can change yours to the iCal by just selecting that there. Your days per week are going to be obviously 7, but you can choose them to 5 if you only want the work week. Under the start week on, so my system setting has it set to Sunday, but you can start your week on whatever day you want to start it on. And then if you want to, you can decide, hey, my day starts at 8, it ends at 6. And then you can say, hey, show 12 hours at a time in day view. You can choose that option there. And then those are all general settings. Under accounts, we've already gone over this. This is where you add your different synced up accounts like Google Cal, Outlook Calendar. Under alerts, you can basically get alerts on my Mac, Gmail, iCloud, for events, all day events. And then under advanced, I want to talk about a really important feature. It's called time zone support. We click into turn on time zone support. If you are scheduling calls on Zoom with people from all over the world, which I do for my podcast, then it's very nice to have time zone support that lets you know, hey, it's going to be 6 p.m. your time, but 9 p.m. their time. Very important, right? And then you can choose show week numbers, show events in year view. These are just a couple of different things that are, again, preferences by individuals. So you probably want to look into these just to be sure. All right. And the last section is going to be frequently asked questions or troubleshooting. So if your Apple calendar isn't syncing, so you want to make sure that iCloud sync is enabled and restart the device. So just open up your settings on your Mac, go to right here where you see your iCloud account here, go to iCloud, make sure once you go to see all that the calendar option here under iCloud calendar is over to the right. And then once you've done that, close out of that, restart the Mac, and it should come up. So briefly, one thing people ask me is how do I restore deleted events? You'll actually have to go to iCloud.com, sign in there. And at the bottom of that page, you can select data recovery and then just select restore calendars. So that's a good way to restore events that you may have deleted, but you didn't mean to delete. You can also enable dark mode on the app by going to the settings within the app and go ahead and go to the appearance settings and enable dark mode. And then lastly, if you're not getting notifications on your iOS device, what you'd want to do is open up your settings on your iPhone like I've done here. Once under settings, scroll down to where you see notifications. It'll be midway down the screen there. And then you would just want to locate calendar. So there's calendar right there. Tap into calendar and you can see my notifications are turned off. If you enable those over to the right and green, it will enable. And then you can choose, hey, I want to add notifications for my calendar app on my lock screen or notification center. And you can customize it to your heart's content. And that's it. That's a wrap on this complete overview and tutorial of Apple Calendar. I hope you now have a better understanding of how to use the, software. And if you found this video helpful, give it a like. And don't forget to subscribe for more great tutorials like this. Let me know if you have any further questions in the comment section below. And we'll see you guys in the next video.